When I was about 8 years old, I had it in my mind that I wanted to go to college. No one in my family kind of was able to direct me because they hadn't been, but I knew that it was something that I wanted to do, and I always had dreams about being in the healthcare field. It wasn't until my senior year where a high school professor kind of reached out to me and said that I should choose Georgia Tech. And because of his guidance, I was able to apply and get in. Upon getting my acceptance letter and kind of doing more research and reaching out to Georgia Tech, I decided that this is where I should be. Challenge about being first gen is just the idea of not knowing what you don't know. There's so many different avenues you can go. There's so many different pathways through Georgia Tech. I come from low income. No one in my family has gone to college, and I think people perpetuate the stereotype of like generations repeat themselves, in that it's really hard to take yourself out of like a lower economic status and elevate yourself into a new one.
When Keaira was in her senior year and she was on her way off to college, I had so much anxiety because I didn't know how to assist her. I didn't know where to go. Just a lot of being scared and worried because I didn't know. I wasn't experienced. I didn't have the knowledge to help guide her.
As a first generation student, I came in just knowing school. You go to class, you get good grades, and you move on to the next semester until you graduate. But there's study abroad, there's internships, there's research, and I feel like the biggest challenge was just ultimately finding what else I was passionate about besides just going to school and going to class. I had to really find my place on campus. And I found it in like just student orgs like NSBE, National Society of Black Engineers. I joined like GT Crew. I, you know, started GT Gymnastics. So I think just trying to get out of my comfort zone and put myself in uncomfortable situations so that, you know, I could have that personal growth like outside of the classroom too.
Seeing how that she's been growing here with leadership roles, how she's been able to step outside of her box, it's been uplifting to me as well. Like I've been growing with her. For other parents who's going through this for the first time in their life with their children going off to college, who have never been able to experience it before themselves, do not give up. To have faith that their child can make it. Do not let the financial worries of college deter them. Speak to the counselors. The counselors at the school are available to assist. All those barriers that is up front can be knocked down.
Being the first in my family to go to college is humbling because you understand that like not many kids from where I come from have the same opportunity to do that. To a high school student, I would say they should, one, just keep their dreams open, two, ask all questions, any questions you have. But three, I think is the most important, is the importance of a higher education and the impact it can have. College can uplift you mentally, but also be, you know, financially beneficial for your entire family. In May, when I graduate, I will be moving to San Francisco to work as a consulting analyst with Accenture.
I am so proud to have Keaira as my oldest child and being the first one to go to college because she's such an inspiration. She has went from being the mentee to the mentor by, you know, accomplishing her goals. She set it early and she has accomplished it. I am so proud of you. You are so wonderful. You are my inspiration. You're just wonderful, darling. And I want to be like you one day. Keep doing it. Keep striving for the best. All right, I love you.
Oh.